Vampire Survivors looks so simple. I bet it's only like, I don't know, 10 lines of code?
I mean, it's one banana, Michael. What could it cost? $10?
But seriously, it is not. This game is much more complex than it looks, and still, we will try to make something similar in just 10 lines of code.
Can we do it?
I don't know, but we will suffer. A good Vampire Survivors-like needs a few things. Juicy weapons, evolutions, champion enemies, chests of course, and meta progression. But on this channel, we aim for the bare minimum. So let's get the basics in first. We need a player, we need tons of enemies, and they need to respawn. Oof. And then we need to kill those enemies with tons of bullets. That might be the worst part, actually killing stuff. We also need some kind of leveling.
So if we count this all together, we have 2.5 lines for each feature.
Oh boy.
We need to lay some ground rules. We use Godot because we like it. In this engine, you could cramp everything in one line with semicolons. But using a semicolon counts as a line because this would be stupid. Okay, I think we can do this. 2.5 lines is not that bad. Let's start with something easy for motivation. For the background, we can just use a very large tile map. Of course, there are much more efficient ways to do this, but a tile map should be simple and fast to do. We can even add some alternate tiles with an atlas. Just draw a large border and we use the fill tool. It seems to take a second to fill. Or two, or... So, it took 2 minutes. But here we are with a large field of grass.
Now that this went so smoothly, let's add the player scene. Give it a sprite with a nice animation. This is going great. Let's give it a script. Oh damn, what is this? Can we get rid of that?
No, not really.
Okay, does it count as a line?
Pretty clearly, yeah.
So, we have 1.5 lines left to make a player controller. We need a process loop, there is really no way around that. It's a function that gets called every frame. But we still don't do anything. For the movement, we just need the inputs WASD and build a vector out of that. Easy and just... Okay, we can't do it like this. We need to compress this by a lot. First of all, we can subtract opposing sides from each other when we cast them to it. This removes a lot. We now can build a vector 2 with both components at once. And there we are, with just 3 lines. That's too much. I'm pretty sure the other features will be harder than this, so we will need to find a way to reduce the number of lines later. But we can move in just 3 lines. That's not bad actually. And don't forget to add the camera as a child so it moves with the player. No code? Nice.
Okay, let's add the enemies. This can't be much harder, can it? Can it? We do the same stuff, physics with the physics process, but we need to move towards the player, so we navigate to it in the scene tree. Calculate the vector towards and move with a fixed speed. Okay, a bit of an ugly line, but it should work. And it does! There is one enemy. We can make it many more just by mapping a billion of them? That sounds bad. I think we need to spawn them in. This could be a bit ugly as we are on 6 lines right now. Maybe we can just delete this new line here. It actually works, only if we have no other statements within this function, but for now we can remove that new line and are back down on 4 lines. Okay, we should add a spawner, which costs a line by itself. And then we need to load a scene, instantiate it and position that thing. For the position, we just take a random position on a circle around the player. Yes, this works. But we cannot use 5 lines for this. We cannot even delete this space this time, for some reason.
This is expensive. We are at 9 lines, and still we need to shoot. Don't panic, we will just start with a bullet. It needs to move and collide. Okay, maybe panic a little. It's time for dirty tricks. We cannot waste code for the movement path, but we can use an animation player to give it a nice spiral motion. This is actually quite neat. And when the Diablo 2 hammered in and Nomad Survivors can do this, then we are allowed to as well. We have to add another function to the player to spawn the bullet, which is triggered by a looping animation. Adding the bullet as a child node under the player makes it move with the player, but at least it's automatically positioned on the player. Now we need to script the bullet. We can cram the collision code into a single line. We just delete the enemy when we collide with it. Oh wait, we can even give it an animation player and play a dev animation before. The dev animation will free the enemy at the end. It still moves after it dies, but I guess there's nothing we can do about this. Wait, we can disable the physics process in the animation. Let's flash the sprite on impact too. It will just look so much more polished, with just a little flash shader. Shaders are code. Okay, we just turned the modulate really, really high.
Okay, we can kill stuff. But we are over our line count at that point and still have scaling to do. How? Honestly, how? We can combine these two lines, but then we have no reference to the enemy to set its position. But maybe the enemy can do it itself. The ready function of the enemy is called as soon as it is added to the scene. We just need to navigate to the player. So we save two lines.
Oh, and another thing is, we can let the player spawn the enemies. This is terrible software design, but it's kind of the point of the whole challenge. So move it over and we save a line.
We don't need a spawner script anymore. And one more thing, wouldn't it be amazing if the enemies could collide with each other? For that, we change them into kinematic body 2Ds and give them a collision shape. Instead of changing its position directly, we have to call move and slide. We are back at 9 lines. That's surprisingly good. But no way this is enough for a level up screen. We need to improvise a bit. Let's just increase the player's attack rate and the enemy spawn rate based on another animation player that animates the animation speed of the other animation players. This actually works. The game gets faster. It would be really cool if the player and enemies would also walk faster. But we don't want to declare a variable because it costs a line. Oh, but we can increase the movement speed by animating the animated sprite's speed scale and read that in the script as our speed. So the animation is faster and the actual speed as well.
Oh, and yeah, we cannot lose yet. We sacrifice another line to detect the enemy hitbox. Then we play an animation and I don't know what else. We could delete the player, but that would just crash the game. So maybe we restart the game with get tree reload current scene. But I don't know how to teach that to the dev animation without using another line. So it's either or. Let's go with restarting. And I guess that's all we get out of 10 lines. There's some things missing, of course, especially the moonwalking skeletons are a thing. But do you have any ideas how we can save a line? Let us know in the comments. Also, let us and YouTube know if you want more videos like this by pushing the like button.